Hiya, welcome to my channel, The Kitchen Web. Please be safe. Today's recipe is highly nutritious and great for Weight Watchers. It's spinach and broccoli paratha. Spinach and broccoli both are superfoods for those in their weight loss journey. So both are loaded with tons of nutrients and the best part is they are low in calories. So who says diet food is not yummy? Before we start, please hit the red subscribe button and click on the bell icon for my latest videos, and it's free. So let's zoom in. So I've got one broccoli here. You just need to and just cut it into small florets. Cut it like this. If you don't have broccoli, you can use cauliflower too. Cauliflower is equally good for weight loss. I'm gonna grate these florets raw. We are not going to cook the broccoli. I've taken one broccoli floret. Just need to grate it like this. So you can have a look here. It's come really nice and fine. You can even use a food processor if you want. But I feel the right consistency is got only when you grate it. So like this, you need to grate all the florets. See, I have grated it so fine. Now let's just give it a quick stir fry. I've taken a pan, put 2 spoons of oil, add a little bit of jeera, wait till it sizzles. I've added a spoon of green chilies. If you want, you can add more. You can even add red chili powder. I've added a little bit of ginger paste. You can even grate ginger if you want. Grated broccoli, a little bit of salt, a pinch of turmeric, coriander powder, jeera powder, you can see that once I added salt, the broccoli is leaving a little bit of water. Add a spoon of red chili powder. Give it a stir. This is almost done. If you don't have broccoli, you can use cauliflower. Broccoli and cauliflower, they both resemble to me as a miniature tree. It's a great source of vitamin K and C and folate. It's loaded with fiber and antioxidants. So both of them are really good. So if you don't have broccoli, you can replace it with cauliflower. So let's switch off the gas and keep it for cooling. I've got few spinach leaves here. Just wash them. You can either cut it very finely, but I prefer to just use it as whole, and we're going to boil cooked like a bit soft. The palak is nicely boiled, so we'll keep it, we'll drain the water and then let the spinach cool for some time so that we can add the spinach in the flour. I've taken 2 cups of wheat flour and I've added the boiled spinach leaves. You can even puree the spinach if you want, but I prefer it like that because it gives a nice taste, nice look and nice texture. I will add a little bit of ajwain. No paratha is complete without ajwain. A little bit of salt. If you don't add flour, that's also fine. I'll just give it a mix. Now since spinach is boiled, so it will have a little bit of water in it, so you can adjust the water accordingly. Yeah, I've done the dough. You can add a spoon of oil. Rest it for about 20 to 30 minutes. See the color? It's come very nicely. If you puree the spinach, the color will be uniform. It'll be like totally green. Now because I've not pureed it and I've just smashed it, you can see it's like strands of spinach. It looks lovely. Make round balls like this. Sprinkle some flour. Should be fine. Take a little bit of stuffing. place it in between. You can add more stuffing as you want and as you wish. 2 spoons should be fine. Just fold it. Try to make it like a bundle. Give it a slight tap, like this. Sprinkle it with flour. And gently roll it. You shouldn't add much of pressure, because that's how parathas are made, or the stuffing will tend to come out. This is highly nutritious because it's got the benefits of spinach as well as broccoli. You can add a bit more flour on top. To make this paratha for beginners, if those who find it difficult to stuff it in. This is for beginners. If you're finding it difficult to roll the put the stuffing in between and roll it, just make one chapati. It should be fine, right? It's perfect and round. You can make another one here of the same size. Chapati here. You can just place the filling. Oh, it's got a little bit of flour on it, but that's okay. Place the filling uniformly. Here you take another chapati and place it over it. Paratha should be fried in a low to medium flame. You can add in a little bit of ghee. Ghee is definitely not fattening. So those who are on a weight loss journey, please do definitely add ghee to your diet. See, paratha without ghee is not paratha. Cooked. It's done. So let's serve it on a plate.